Expresso's next guest is the organiser of South Africa's biggest boating show, the Cape Town International Boat Show, which takes place this weekend right here in Cape Town. Johnny Malabo, welcome to Expresso.
Yeah, good morning. Thank you, Lisa.
Now, this is an early morning for you. I thought we got you up out of bed very early this morning, and you said it isn't.
No, not at all. Monday morning, we had to start with a build-up, and we brought the biggest of the catamarans indoors, and that has to be traffic escorted. And coming through the doors, it needs proper planning and logistics, and you can't do that any other time because of the size of the boat, and obviously getting up early wasn't too much of a problem.
So it's just all part of a day's work for you.
Yeah, definitely.
My cousin was asking me yesterday, who am I interviewing on the show today? So I mentioned I was interviewing you and we're going to be talking boats. Mm. And she said, Liesel, you come from Pretoria. What does a Pretorian know about boats? There's no boats up there. Why should people come to your show? People who don't know anything about boats, is it accessible for them?
Yeah, it's very accessible. And also, because of the size of the actual industry, the industry is huge. Mm. And up in the Vaal, or Vaalies with the Pretoria
the Vaalies, guys, yeah.
There's lots and lots of power boats. Mm. And Cape Town, obviously, is a big sailing destination. So there's complete area, everything. South Africa is actually number two in the world in catamaran manufacture. So there's a lot more than what people actually think. And a lot of people up country have their dream to sort of set sail into the sunset.
That is a big dream. When I was living overseas, I saw a lot of foreigners setting sail and traveling and just taking their boat out for years and not coming back. Is that a thing that South Africans do at all?
Yes, definitely. We've actually got some friends who visited the first boat show a couple of years ago, and they decided this is what they wanted to do. Once the kids were out of school and out of varsity, they sold up everything and they're actually now sailing.
Wow, that's so romantic.
No, no, fantastic.
Now, it's not only a boat show. You offer other things as well?
Well, it's mostly boating, but it's also destinations. Mm. For example, part of sailing is exotic islands like Seychelles, Mauritius, Cyprus, Caribbean. So I think that's part of the dream when you own your boat, is not just to sail around South African waters.
And the show's been split in two venues this year. Why is that? You're at the Cape Town Convention Centre and you're at the waterfront.
Correct. The reason for that is obviously there are bigger boats that can't get into the convention centre, and they all moored down at the V&A waterfront, and those are the huge, maybe 40 million rand boats. And we transport the people via water taxi.
Oh, I wanted to ask you, how does that work? Well, so you just get on?
You just get on, and the water taxi ferries you through on the water, gets you to the V&A waterfront. When they finish, they come back, they reverse the trip, which is fantastic. And a lot of people don't even know about that canal.
No, I didn't. I'm surprised. No. So is that all part of your ticket, your entrance ticket?
All part of the entrance, all part of the fun. Obviously, we don't have to worry too much about the eating at the CTICC because V&A's got something like 52 restaurants. So people can make a day out of it.
Yeah. And it's a day for the whole family,
of course.
If people haven't got tickets yet, can they still get
tickets? They can get at the door.
On the day?
On the day, they can just walk in. And parking, obviously, there's more than enough because you can park on either side. And I think it's a great thing. Yeah, we're looking forward to it. Show number 10.
Fantastic. I look forward to it. I especially want to go on the canal back and forth. Thank you, Johnny, for joining us here on Expresso.
Thank you very much, Liesel. Thank you.